Adventure Quest 3D is a reimagining of the original web browser game. It's a cross-platform MMORPG that allows people to play together from PC, Mac, Android, or iOS. This game initially released in early access on Steam back in 2016, and due to seeing more people request it recently, I've decided now is the time to jump in and see if it's any good. As of making this video, the game's sitting at mostly positive reviews overall on Steam, and seems to have a fairly stable player population. Before we jump into it though, this video is brought to you by Instant Gaming. Instant Gaming is a great place to compare video game prices across multiple different platforms such as Steam, PlayStation, Xbox, and so on, allowing you to buy games for the lowest possible price via game key reselling. Simply enter the game you're interested in via the search bar, and you'll get a bunch of different options depending on the platform. Additionally, if you don't know what to play, then check out their top 50 bestsellers list to see what's popular. Click the link in the description below to check out Instant Gaming and enter a giveaway to win a game of your choice. So the first thing we're going to do is create a character, and for some odd reason there's a banner that says Breaking Benjamin in the background. I really like that band. I don't know if this is to promote their new album or something, but it's a little bit random seeing that in the background of an MMO. So if I want to, I can randomize my look and... Okay, there's some crazy options. Lots of different hairstyles to choose from. I'm gonna try and find something that kind of resembles myself. You can have any hair color you possibly want. Okay, this beard's so big it's clipping through my armor. Blue skin, green skin, red skin, purple skin. This is the most inclusive MMO in 2020. And I've got the choice between three different classes: mage, warrior, or rogue. It seems as though there's other classes, four other classes, but these are locked. It also says choose your first class, which suggests that later on you unlock a second class. I'm gonna be a good old warrior. The Lazy Peon. Kanshiro. Name. Compost 69. Okay, and we are in the game. The legendary hero Compost 69. Move around with WASD. You can jump. Selfie camera. Yes. Click on the weapon to grab it. I like the way my character looks. Nice and chunky right out the gate. I'm getting a cloak straight away. Nice. That's a cool looking cloak. Defeat 5 skeletons. Level up. New stats. Okay, so every time you level up, it tells you what you've unlocked. First boss, I guess, the Bone Berserker. I've got little telegraphs to avoid. Right now I've only got one real ability. The other thing's my auto attack. Controls a lot like World of Warcraft so far. What's going on? Am I dead? My key to the land of the dead was just stolen. Don't rub it in. I like the dialogue. It doesn't seem like a game that's taken itself too seriously. I need to hide my character's name. It's already winding me up seeing Compost 69 above my head. I'm attacking Death's door. I don't know why Death can't attack his own door, but there we go. Into the land of the dead. Give me Death's key. I don't think he's going to want to give it to me, to be honest. Interesting. Death chose Compost 69 as his champion. In your first life, you was a legend. Okay. Well, we just got absolutely clapped. Is that it? Am I just dead? No? Oh. I'm immortal, remember? Oh my god, I'm getting absolutely destroyed. Is he putting a rock on my head? This whole opening scene's brilliant. If I can't kill you, I will remove you. That is a cool start to an MMO. I like that a lot. So he's thrown me all the way to the starting quest hub, has he? Damn, some of these people look cool. Look at this guy. Interesting that Death is like our friend in this game. You got my key back yet? I haven't, mate. Hello, Jane. Why have you got an exclamation mark above your head? Clicked on some kind of concert. Post-show fireworks. I guess I missed the show. Breaking Benjamin have left the stage. Oh my god, I missed the bloody concert. This person's got a Breaking Benjamin drum. And this person's got a Breaking Benjamin cloak. I've just realized this NPC is called Jane, and it says Breaking Benjamin fan / diary keeper. And that's funny, because Breaking Benjamin had a song called The Diary of Jane. Okay, the concert's starting. Does it actually play the music? No way! That's so fucking cool. Oh, I'm a big fan of this. It actually plays their music and then monsters start invading. You can get up close and have a look at them, can we? I wonder how much Breaking Benjamin had to pay for this marketing. Right out the gates, level 3, and we're already doing a little raid. This is the first MMO concert I think I've ever been to. What happens if I jump off here? Oh, the concert had 3 songs. I've got a lot of loot from it as well. That was super cool. I really enjoyed that. Right off the bat, I've got myself a bloody awesome cosmetic sword. Equipper's cosmetic. I've got this cosmetic helm. Cosmetic wings. Getting cosmetics thrown at me as I enter the game. I didn't expect that from a free-to-play game. Getting back on track, I guess we go to the quest board. Click on the rune. Little cutscene. Okay. Off we go. Concert, new events, random adventure, all levels. Okay, we've just gone through the portal and we're immediately under attack. We've been saved by an archer lady. Robina, original out of 10. The monsters are called Frogzards because they are a cross between frogs and lizards. Genius monster creation right here. Rank up. Megazard defeated, so we need to fight the king frog lizard. Unlocked another ability, a big spinning, big damage ability. Got a green cape. I like that you have the option to equip everything as cosmetic. I can use a bloody guitar as a cosmetic weapon if I want. That's some kind of card on the bridge. Brutal solo and rewards. Sup bro, the pain train is now boarding. What the fuck is that? Is this game just a complete meme or something? It seems like it so far. I need to fight Brutal Corn. I think I'm gonna fall to the mighty Brutal Corn. Die! Oh, we just got him on 12 HP left. Something I can definitely say about this game already is I do think it's lacking sound effects. There's another challenge down here. Level 4 plus, extreme, group of 5, and I get stuff as a reward. Found some treasure under the bridge though. Discovering lots of little hidden things. Some kind of world boss up here, can I join in? Straight away in the starting area, there's lots of little things pulling me in different directions. Lots of little distractions. I didn't get too much XP for killing that, but do I get good loot? Into the cave, and we've got a little monster we need to fight. The hairy little man, me eat him. Great, did you eat his book too? I really need some information. Now me eat you too. Roar. Another epic boss battle, this time against Dead Tooth. There's not a whole lot of strategy to the combat so far. I'm just pressing abilities as they come off cooldown. Elven Guard gloves, very nice. I appreciate that all of the gear in the game so far actually has a cosmetic impact on my character. Recover the sword. Oh, it's a bait. Bit of combat with the UI off. Sword in the stone. Hand it in. This is my new sword. Looks pretty cool. I'm off to a new area by the looks of it. Some kind of solo dungeon or something. We have vanquished Lieutenant Dan. Got some new gloves. Got some new boots. Oh, that's level 4. Shredding these guards now with my newfound power. King Sneed, let's go. This boss has over 1,000 health, so I need to dodge all of his attacks if I'm gonna kill him. I haven't got much health left. We just about got him down, though. Got myself a health. Helmet. A little bit ugly though, isn't it? The combat's not overly thrilling so far. It basically just boils down to pressing everything as soon as it's off cooldown. But to be honest, with this being a cross-platform MMO, I wasn't expecting crazy in-depth combat. Search the King's Throne. Now I just jump off here, I guess. Do you take falling damage? No. Daily chest ready. It's just like a loot box. Fiendish Blood Blade. Wow, that's a pretty cool sword cosmetic I've unlocked. Pig Snout. You what? Level 3. Weird. Solo. Surprise. What the fuck is going on? This monster's just eaten this man? So far, this game seems like the perfect beginner MMO. Nothing too complex, but a good introduction to MMO mechanics and stuff. Okay. You have made a grave mistake coming here. I am the root of all evil. Oh my god, this is the most... He has the same reaction as me. You wouldn't be so foolish as to battle me. Leafs, a birch, then you to ply. Well, evil tree, you definitely deserve what's coming to you after all of that. Not too many mechanics involved with fighting this tree, nothing to dodge or anything. Finally, gonna swap out our starting armor. What does it look like? pretty cool, actually. I look like an elven king, and that's level 5, and I've unlocked an ultimate skill, apparently. That's level 5, and we're in a new zone, certainly a change of tone. We've opened another portal, we're going somewhere else, I guess. I need to tap the rune arch again, so I guess I click on this rune, and it opens yet another portal to a new zone. So based on this portal and the amount of runes, I'm guessing there's 12 different zones in the game, and then I'm guessing the final zone, you go fight a dragon or a boss. Random adventure, all levels. Let's give this a try. Okay, this seems like some kind of solo dungeon type thing. We're inside a tornado by the looks of it, and we need to defeat elementals. Oh god, I've pulled everything. And my ulti doesn't do AoE, which kind of sucks for me. Onto the final boss. 28 health. He's dead. I guess we just go here, and that's it. And that's the adventure. I can buy a travel form and turn into a wolfling, apparently. I can't help but feel like the proportions of this travel form are a little bit off. I'm a wolf, but I'm the size of a rat. Oh my god, and the run animation. This is the most scuffed travel form I've ever seen. Here's my new friend. I bet she's got a Tumblr page. I think the game's opening up a little bit. This new zone I've gone into seems a lot bigger than the previous zones. Big turtle. Monsters coming in hot. The most classic of classic MMO quests. Kill 5 wolves. Collecting wolf meat over the years has become an iconic staple of the MMO. I thought this was a werewolf, but it turns out it's a humanoid boar. The developers of this game love combining different species. This would be a good MMO to play before bed, because it's putting me to sleep. It is a bit of an endless barrage of kill and collect. Probably the most standard MMO questing I've seen for a while. It's certainly not the most engaging MMO, and I think the reason it's putting me to sleep is probably due to the combat system just being something where you're going through the motions. I'll go for another 15 minutes and I'm just going to take a nap. The repetitive music and lack of sound effects are also contributing to my feeling of sleepiness playing this as well. We're under attack by a boss by the looks of it. A little boss fight with our NPC friends. Got some stuff to dodge, I appreciate that. I always find it a bit weird when you defeat a boss with actual gameplay, but then in the cutscene it shows the boss not being defeated. It's like two different things are happening. Numlock also doesn't seem to auto-run you forward either, so you need to run everywhere. Burn the camp, burn it to the ground. It's a bit weird how there's two different XP bars. You've got your class XP bar, then you've got your overall XP bar. And it seems as though the one on the left moves from doing quests, and the one on the right moves from just grinding mobs. I'm sure there's a good reason for it, but whatever that reason is, it's not apparent to me at the moment. Level 6. So the way this game's class system works is you pick your starter class, warrior, mage, or rogue, then you pick a tier 1 class after you've finished leveling that up. So if you look here, warrior rank 6, and it can go to rank 10. So I'm assuming that upon hitting rank 10, I can then specialize into being a guardian, dragon slayer, pirate, paladin, necromancer, ninja, or mogulomancer. I've never heard of that class in an MMO before, but okay. Oh, I need to unlock it with these things, dragon crystals. Stereotypical talk to grandfather treant quest. I think I'm gonna call it there. So after playing Adventure Quest 3D for a bit, my first impressions of the game are as follows. The game has cool armor, lots of cosmetics, it gives you a sense of visual progression, and has a cool transmog system. The game's cross-platform, so you can play it on the go. I enjoyed the game's light-hearted humor. It doesn't take itself too seriously. I liked the little challenges you can find around the world. It helped break up the questing, and I was a big fan of the in-game Breaking Benjamin concert. It's actually got me listening to their music again. The game's background music seems very short and very repetitive. This contributed heavily to making me want to sleep. The game seems to be missing a lot of sound effects from other players' attacks to monster attacks and so on. The transitions between gameplay to cutscenes were very abrupt and janky. It doesn't seem like there's much depth to the combat other than just press what's off cooldown. And the questing is very standard kill and collect. I didn't see any creativity such as puzzles or challenging content to keep you engaged. Overall, to me, Adventure Quest 3D seems like a good MMORPG by mobile standards, but by PC standards, it seems to lack depth compared to other big games in the genre. I think this is a criticism for most cross-platform designed MMOs, really. To make an MMORPG playable on mobile, it needs to have a lower skill ceiling, very few abilities, and mechanics can't be too hard, which results in people playing it on PC getting bored. But if you're looking for a good mobile MMORPG, I think it's worth playing, but for a good PC MMORPG, there's better options unless you have a potato computer that can't run anything else. I guess it's also a good MMO to introduce kids to the genre with due to its simplicity and family-friendly vibe. But that's it for this video, guys. As always, let me know your thoughts on Adventure Quest 3D in the comments below. Let me know if the combat gets better later on, and what do you think about MMOs having in-game concerts with real music? Is that something you'd like to see more of? Thanks for watching. I hope you all have a great day, and I'll see you again really soon.